Okay, two analogies or visualizations to show what's happening in a dynamic equilibrium. First, the conveyor belt analogy. So we have reactants on the left, which are going to be converted into products. So we start up the wheel on the left, representing starting up the reaction. And reactants begin to form products. You can see on the right in red, products begin to form. Now, shortly after we begin to form products, the reverse reaction begins to kick in and products start turning back into reactants. So the reaction is reversible. Eventually, the rate at which products turn back into reactants equals exactly the rate at which reactants turn into products. And at this point, the two wheels are traveling at the same speed but in opposite directions. And there with the blue and red arrows, we have the arrows used to represent a system in a state of a dynamic equilibrium. The so-called Haber process dynamic equilibrium is represented there in the background, where nitrogen and hydrogen gases react to form ammonia gas. And here you see the dynamic equilibrium has been reached. At this point, the rate at which nitrogen and hydrogen react to form ammonia will be exactly matched by the rate at which ammonia decomposes to produce nitrogen and hydrogen. I'm inferring in this analogy that the equilibrium lies far to the right by the fact that products is printed in larger print. In the Haber process, the use conditions something like 400 degrees centigrade and 200 atmospheres pressure, where one has about a 20% yield of products. So it would be the other way around. The equilibrium would lie far to the left hand side. But when the dynamic equilibrium is established, the rates of the two opposing processes are equal. And of course there is equi in the word equilibrium, and equi comes from the fact that the rates of the two opposing processes, the forward and reverse reactions, are equal. You see this animation again at a greater speed, and there's the dynamic equilibrium has established. The forward and reverse reactions continue, but at the same speed. Now here's another visualization using an escalator. So as you can see, the person is traveling down an up escalator. So no progress is being made because as quickly as he's going down, the escalator is going up. So here we have an escalator representing two opposing processes, the movement of the person downwards, the movement of the escalator upwards. And if the rates of the two processes are the same, then no progress will be made. What I've done here is to change the so-called position of the equilibrium. Changing the reaction conditions may change the position where the equilibrium is established. That's to say, it may establish far to the left, where relatively little of the reactants have turned into products, or it may be the other way around and establish when most of the reactants have been converted to products. So then, in conclusion, in any dynamic equilibrium situation, one will find two opposing processes that are occurring at the same rate. We say that there are no macroscopic changes, but there are microscopic changes. That's to say, to the eye, it appears as if the two processes have stopped, but at the microscopic level, in fact, both continue to occur, but at the same rate. So there you have it, my two different analogies for a dynamic equilibrium.